We're on Yevamot Perakei Mishnah Gimel. We're going to continue to talk about the idea, is there something after Ma'amar, if there's something after Get, after Chalitza, after Yibum. Meaning you have a regular case, okay? And you have a regular case, and well, let's look at it here, okay? And Reuven has to do Yibum on Leah or Chalitza, and either he does Ma'amar, or he does Chalitza, or he gives her a Get. So this is the discussion our Mishnah is talking about. Not on get, okay? He gave a get, and let's look about it. Sorry, I don't want to flip too much. Not on get, v'asa ma'amar, tzricha get v'chalitza. Now we'll flip, okay? He gave her a get, okay? So instead, so she's zikuka liyibum. So first he gave her a get, and then he did ma'amar. But we learned that once you give a get, he can no longer marry her. So therefore, even though he did kiddushin, he's not allowed to consummate the marriage. Therefore, he has to give her another get to remove the ma'amar, and then he has to do chalitza because the get never removed the zikat yibum. So he got zikat get v'chalitza. He has to do a get again. Why? The get, when the first get, dache ksat, v'shiyar ksat, it pushed off something. U'ma'amar kani shiyur the get. The ma'amar then removed the what's left of the get. Hilcha, therefore. So zikat get the ma'amar ro, v'chalitza the zikato. You have to do have a get for the ma'amar and a chalitza for the zikat. Next case, Natan get uba'a. So he's not allowed to do that. If he gave her a get, then he, remember, he has to do chalitza. It's below yibne. That's a deed. They're coming out late below yibne. He's not allowed to marry her anymore. He was not allowed to do that. Okay? Therefore, tzricha get v'chalitza. Okay? He was required the bi'ila, the relations, the marital intimacy that they had, wasn't Yibum, because once he gave her the get, there is no Yibum anymore. So that was an Isur. So therefore, she still has Zika the Yibum. So he has to give her a get, because he slept with her. And Chalitza, he has to Chalitza to remove the Zika the Yibum. Next case. Natan get v'chalatz. He gave her get, and then he did Chalitza. Ein achar Chalitza klum. Chalitza doesn't have any meaning at all. Okay, we're going to see that this is only according to one position. We'll see in a second. Therefore, Chalatz. If he did Chalitza first, then v'asa ma'amar. Then he did ma'amar. He's not allowed to. Once he does chalitza, there's no zika, and she's his brother's wife. Once he does, let's say, Shimon dies, and then Reuven does chalitza. Okay, now Leah is eshet achiv, asher lo yivneh. He can't marry her. Nothing he does has any effect, well, according to this opinion. We'll see in a second, according to this opinion. Therefore, if he did chalitza, then ma'amar. Or, natan get, he gave her get. Uba'al, or he slept with her even. That's Asur. He wasn't allowed to do that. Okay, does it have any effect? We'll see in a second. Or Ba'al. Let's say he did Yibum. Then Ma'amar, nobody cared. Okay, Ma'amar is fine, doesn't mean anything. Natan get, if he gave her get afterwards. V'chalat, I did Chalitza. Ein achar Chalitza klum. I mean, these are all the order that you could do these things in, but after Chalitza, nothing you do is meaningful. One second. Bartunera says, and the Gemara says, "Hamat nitin Rabbi Akiva hi." This is Rabbi Akiva de Amar, who says, "Ein kiddushin tovsin b'chay ve'lavin." Remember, we said once he does ma'amar, she is now eshet achiv. So therefore, there's a lav. Reuven is asur d'oraita to marry Leah. If you marry someone, you're asur d'oraita to marry. Is kiddushin tovsin? Is she married or not? So Rabbi Akiva says no, and that's one of the reasons Rabbi Akiva says there's mamzerut. Remember, we said in that case of a lav, she's not married to you. It doesn't work. Chachamim argue and say, no, Kiddushin Artovs, and a Kohen marries a Grusha, the marriage is affected. It is a marriage. It's Asur, but it's a marriage. So here too, the Chachamim will argue on Rabbi Akiva and say, there is Kiddushin. So therefore, Rabbi Akiva said, "En Kiddushin Tovsin Mechai Be'lavin," therefore, once he does Chalitza, Chalatz, then afterwards, Asa Ma'amar, is that meaningful? But the Chachamim argue and say, it is meaningful if he married someone who is Chalitza to him. "En Echar Chalitza Klum," that's Rabbi Akiva's position. Mishavadi concludes, achat yavama achat liyavam echad. This is true whether it's one yavam to one yavama for one yavam, the case that we describe, one woman for one man, the achat shtei yavamot liyavam echad. And this will also be true, this rule of Rabbi Akiva of Enki Divshin Tovsin, if you're talking about two yavamot to one yavam. We're going to discuss this in the next case, but let's say Reuven was married to two women named Leah and Leah too. I'm sorry, excuse me. Shimon was married to two women. And then when Shimon dies, both women fall to Yibum. So the question will be, in our next mission, we're going to discuss what happens if Reuven does Ma'amar to one, or if he does Yibum to another, etc., etc., etc. Stay tuned for Mishnah Gimel. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. As always, you can find all these Mishnayot at Mishnah.co, and you can email me if you have comments or questions. Have a good day.